In this video, we're going to see how to diagonalize an operator, the second derivative operator, on functions on an interval. Now, whenever you deal with a derivative operator, you need boundary conditions. And we're going to apply Dirichlet boundary conditions, which is to say that we're interested in functions that vanish at both ends of our interval. So our vector space is square integrable functions on the interval from 0 to L. We want f of 0 to always be 0. We want f of L to always be 0. So our operator is d squared by dx squared, and we want to find its eigenvalues and its eigenvectors. The first thing to notice is that the first derivative operator is anti-Hermitian. The adjoint of the first derivative is minus the first derivative. And the way to see that is we just see what happens when we take the inner product of f with the derivative of g. By definition, that's the integral of f bar times g prime dx. And we can do that integral by parts. This is our v. This is our du. Or if you prefer, this is u and this is dv. So you get uv minus the integral of v du. Now, because of our boundary conditions, this term is 0. G of 0 is 0. G of L is 0. F of 0 is 0. F of L is 0. So we don't need this term. And this term is exactly minus the inner product of the derivative of f with g. So minus a derivative applied to f has the same effect as a derivative applied to g. So the adjoint of the derivative is the minus derivative. Okay. Now, that tells us what the adjoint of our operator a is. A is a second derivative. In other words, the derivative of the derivative. And the adjoint of the product of two operators is the product of the adjoints in the opposite order. So instead of a d by dx and a d by dx, you have a d by dx and a d by dx. So it's minus d by dx times minus d by dx, which is d squared by dx squared, which is a again. So the operator that we're studying, the second derivative operator, is Hermitian. So what does that buy us? Well, just like on finite dimensional spaces, Hermitian operators have real eigenvalues. The eigenvectors are orthogonal. And it's always diagonalizable. Now, I have to be a little bit careful about what diagonalizable means. It has a spectral decomposition, which is the infinite dimensional analog of diagonalizable. For our purposes, let's just say it's diagonalizable. And so we need to find all the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors, and we only need to check real eigenvalues because it's Hermitian. So we want to solve the equation AF equals lambda F with the boundary conditions that we set. Now, we only have to consider real eigenvalues. We're going to consider positive ones, negative ones, and zero. So first, let's look for some positive eigenvalues. So we want AF, that's the second derivative of F, to be a positive multiple of f. Well, we know the solution to that equation. It's cosches and sinches. It involves the square root of the eigenvalue, but it's cosches and sinches. OK, we studied this equation using t's instead of x's, but it's the same equation. And then we plug in our boundary conditions. Since f of 0 is 0, c1 times a cosh of 0 plus c2 times a sinh of 0 is 0. Cosh of 0 is 1, sinh of 0 is 0, so c1 is 0. So this term is gone. And then we plug in our boundary condition at the other end. We get that c2 times the sinh of root lambda l is 0. Well, that means that c2 is 0. So this term is gone. So the only solution to second derivative equals lambda f is if f equals 0, and that doesn't count as an eigenvector. So there are no positive solutions to the system of equations. So there are no positive eigenvalues. Next, we check for zero eigenvalues. We have to solve the equation AF equals 0F. Well, the second derivative is 0, and the first derivative must be a constant, and the function must be a constant plus another constant times x. We use the same reasoning as the positives. The value at 0 tells you that c1 is 0, and then the fact that it's 0 at the other end tells you that c2 is 0. So the only solution Here is f equals 0. It doesn't work. No non-trivial solutions. 0 is not an eigenvalue. So what we're left with is looking for negative eigenvalues. So we want to look for eigenvalues of the form minus omega squared. And these work. You see, the solution to second derivative is minus omega squared f. Well, that's cosines and sines of omega x. Since 0 is f of 0, well, that tells you that c1 is 0 as before. So this is gone. And our function has to be c2 sine of omega x. But now when you say that 0 is f of l, you don't have to set c2 equals 0. You could have sine of omega l equals 0. And if sine of omega l is 0, then omega l has to be a multiple of pi, which means omega has to be a multiple of pi over l. So there are our eigenvalues. Our eigenvalues are minus omega squared, so that's minus n squared pi squared over l squared. And our eigenvectors are sine of n pi x over l. We've seen this before. This is Fourier series. The eigenvectors of the second derivative operator are exactly the Fourier modes. And when we decompose a function in a Fourier series, we're just decomposing in a basis of eigenvectors. And how do we know that it really forms a basis? Well, it's because it's a Hermitian operator. Hermitian operators are diagonalizable. So let's sum up what we know. The eigenvalues of our operator are minus n squared pi squared over l squared. The eigenvectors are sine of n pi x over l. I say vectors. Sometimes we call them eigenfunctions because they're functions of x, but they live in a vector space, the vector space L2. The eigenvalues are real, and the eigenvectors are orthogonal because our operators is Hermitian. Now, we checked that these were orthogonal by hand before, but they got to be orthogonal because A is Hermitian. And the eigenvectors form a basis. Now, Fourier series is really good for problems involving A because then we're decomposing in a basis of eigenvectors. Two examples we're going to study in future videos. One is the heat equation. The heat equation says the first partial derivative with respect to t is a constant times ax, times the second derivative with respect to x. And you should think of that as being just like the equation dx dt equals ax, except now it's not x, it's a function, and we're in an infinite dimensional space. But it works the same way. You find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors, and you write down the solution. The wave equation is the same thing, only with a second derivative with respect to t. And that behaves just like the second derivative of x with respect to t being a matrix times x. If you understand these problems, which we did in section 5.1 and section 5.2 and 5.3, then you understand these infinite dimensional problems. And that's the glory of Hermitian operators, second derivative operator, and Fourier series.